Oh, hello. All right, good morning. Morning, Internet. I'd have been out for a while, but I was just kind of messing around, so I got something working. I got something. Hopefully everything works in. So all right, so I'm saving this work. So, because I realized that we already have the lock. So, we don't need to do this whole shebang because when we. I think I'm realizing this thing about meta issue body is because we don't have the overlay on the flow, the n equals 2 flow. And like the flow level equals 2, like we talked about the different flow levels. So then I'm like, do we actually want to reuse the input network? Is there any reason not to? Now that we've reused the redundancy checker. And I think there isn't. And then I was like, what about the lock network? And I think that's where maybe we need to ditch the. I think it's connected. Okay, so I think it's connected. Okay, so I think we do need to reuse the lock network. We're just adding in the new input under a new context. So the context captures the parent information, and if you need to traverse it, because if your parent equals none, your parent is the context input wise. Okay. just realized I'm going to be able to watch these videos when I get back. I probably have no idea what I'm doing, so this is great. Okay, yeah. Okay, fantastic. Okay, I was really worried about getting, like, totally context switch, but now I can totally context switch because everything is written down. Awesome. Okay. Okay. So yeah, we were just talking about reusing. So where is that? Did we not do that reuse thing? Reuse. Did we never end up using it? Yeah. We not end up using it? It could like accidentally stashed somewhere. Basically just figured out what the right inputs were somehow. Oh yeah, we auto-flowed. Okay. So you know, I think if we just reuse the input network. Okay, but then okay, so if you do have the case where you don't want to return out of the parent in the top level flow, you, okay, so here, if we look at this, right? So, this commit C89D3D8444. Okay, and we are in Allospace configured recommended community standards CLI, and we're looking at CLI run on repo. Okay, so this thing here, we're debating, should it take, okay, so let's not, maybe let's just not worry about it right now. Well, okay, so overlay CLI dataflow. So this is basically saying, okay, so this still has that bug. Okay, so they're both the same. They're just the exact same. Let's split this out into its own function. Okay, and we'll call it Sigma Custom. So Okay, so this would be So okay. I think this is the generic form. What is it? It's new context. Honestly, this is just adding a new context. Like, this is overly complicated. Okay, wait a minute. This is so easy. Okay, fuck. Oops. Wow. God, okay. I don't even know what to say about this. Okay, I must really be in need of a break. Because, wow, we were in here looking at these methods the other day. Okay, and we're going to put network context, input set, basic input set. Memory input set with an existing context. String input set context. Right. It's okay, so but this was should have been cadd. Okay. But yeah, so basically cadd. Okay, list args, okay. Wow, okay. So that was a really overly complicated way of doing that. I knew that if I went to sleep, I would come back and certain things would make sense. I didn't know just exactly what those things were. So, we spent a long time on that. Damn. Okay. Interesting. Well, it was interesting. We learned. So, I think, I'm not sure. I'm not sure if they learned anything, actually. So, other than that, once again, there's a million ways to do the same thing. So, So okay, let's just do this. What happens? OCTX.ICTX.CAD. Okay, so we shouldn't fuck with this right now. Anything else? It's time to just go back to what we have. Okay, so all right, so let's visualize the flow again. Okay, so we're visualizing the flow because we're about to change it. Okay. All right. Okay, so here's what we've got. This thing still isn't connected for whatever reason, but whatever. Okay, readme PR seems to get created, yes, because here it is. And it's trying, it's not working. Okay, so now what are we gonna do? Okay, I need my tea. All right, let's copy paste and pray that please, 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 this works. Okay, so let's go. Delete that pull request. Okay, so then what we're going to do is copy and paste all this readme stuff. Copy and then paste. Okay, and now we're going to rename everything that says readme to contributing. So, yeah, first we're going to do the title. And then we're going to do the all caps version. Do the lowercase. All right, so now let's run it and see what happens. So where was the, okay, so here's the body. Great. See what happens. Hold on. Okay, so it got the README. Oh, but we didn't include the. Okay. So let's add contributing. Okay, so the README overlay. Routine, right? So we got to overlay those on the contributing one as well. And then we have to reinstall to take effect. We need to enable it on this as well. So overlay README is README contributing. As we find and replace that too. And then reinstall whatever package those entry points are in. Where is this? Okay, I don't think that's related to us. It's something else. All right, okay, so. Let's run it. All right, so it has the contributing file, but not the README now. Did I find and replace the wrong area? Contributing. Maybe those definitions were too loose. Need to read me. Okay, so let's see, it looks like we have it in the overlays. Try Visualizing that. So contributing readme file, contributing file does not exist. Okay, contributing file does not exist. Shooting PR, reading PR. Another issue. Okay, let's remove the meta issue for now. Create readme file does not exist, create contributing file does not exist. So those two are both going off into nowhere land right now. Contribute readme, let's contribute contributing. So what is this? So this has two arrows. That's repo streaming directory, or your repo to Alice get repo will both go there. Okay, but why didn't you run the other one? And you run the other one. Okay, so now I'm going to run the readme one. Or no, now we're going to contribute. Okay, so. Let's so now it has remove an intercontrusion. So intruding PR. Okay. It's not. All right, so I'm just making this so that it does this because or else I don't have time to keep going back and forth. So getting this wrong. we're going to close all the DFFML peers. Okay. All right, so now let's enable them both. And let's see the logs as to why they're not working together. Or maybe they are, and we just didn't get a cleaner. Okay, no, they are not. Okay, so we saw this create blank if not exist doesn't seem to be connected. All right, so only either readme or contributing is currently being added when we run with our new contributing overlaid. Okay, so okay, so we used our little trick to make this more readable. Okay, so Les can have the line scroll offset. So let's see. Let's go to the end. Contributing, overlay contributing. Git repo to Alice, git repo, match with client, we did git repo to Alice, git repo. Then we see overlay GitHub buttons remote, Alice contribute readme. Okay, Alice contribute readme dispatch. Dispatch as contribute readme. That's good. So, because what we got was, I assume, the contributing. Okay. Okay. Dispatch as contribute readme. Acquiring. Okay, so it tries to acquire the lock. So let's go look for the lock. Okay, so okay, so here it is. Now it's held down here. It's held by the contributing. So overlay get determine default branch. So let's yeah. Okay, so it'll be okay. All right. Oh.